Today's sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Las Vegas, Nevada. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Cleveland Browns and the Las Vegas Raiders.
Set to kick off.
And off we go from Las Vegas. Fielded in the end zone. And no run back on this one, so the new season will begin at the 25-yard line. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
The 28-yard
line. A gain of 3, second down.
3. Brings up 2nd and 7.
Let's check in with our referee. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for 1st and 10. Defensive end Danielle Hunter drops him.
All right, partner, I'm going to be Captain Obvious right here. Not the start you're looking for offensively, right? Incomplete pass, followed by a sack.
And when he went down, it looked like that right ankle got turned, but thankfully he popped up okay, and they breathed a sigh of relief on that sideline. So 2nd and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Now it's Ryan. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. And it'll be intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And he's past the 25. They may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared. But I'm with you. Okay, so it didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
Is Leonard Fournette. And they get him down, but not before takes it across the 40-yard line. First play of the drive, going for 14 and a first down.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
They keep it with Fournette on first down. Tackle made by the longtime member of these Browns, Joe Schobert.
End result of that one, a nice four-yard gain. So you can use that to set up your play-action game, or you can come right back and continue to run the football, because as an offensive play caller, you're on schedule and feeling pretty good about your next couple of calls.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Now Leonard Fournette. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield after a gain of about four.
On the carry.
Two straight four-yard runs, and it is steadily working the ball downfield. To me, they're staying right on schedule. First down, you want 4 yards or more to set up the rest of the drive. They're getting exactly that.
For it with Fournette, and he's got the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 49. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 49-yard line. A toss running left. Fournette. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. Was that five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it.
That's caught by the tight end, Irv Smith Jr. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle comes at the Raiders 36. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Cleveland.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll toss it to Fournette. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
He was taken down.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he
able to get it down to the 25-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
First down carry. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6.
Something to watch here in week one of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus, the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. This is Fournette. And this time not as successful as he'll get back. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd down and 6.
And it's 3rd down.
The first down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11. What a methodical drive this is turning out to be. That time 9 yards, and the sticks move again. Now a 1st and 10 at the 11. Down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. What we call run fits, everyone was in the right place.
Now 2nd and 9 from the 10. Back to throw, Watson. And he'll score. Touchdown, Browns. A 10-yard touchdown run as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. Well, the defensive coverage was good, so good he just decided to make a play of his own, and it worked out.
Yeah, you often wonder if they think to themselves, was the coverage too good to allow him to run the football? I think you'd rather take your chances with him doing exactly that, and he beat him on that play all the way to the end zone.
Steven Gostkowski set to kick off.
Gostkowski now after the touchdown. He'll send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive. They had the auspicious beginning to the season, a first drive turnover. Now they'll try again here, 1st and 10. Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. They'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially. 6 yard line.
Ready, ready.
Ryan. Got his man complete over the middle. That's long. They'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Another first down there as this one goes for 25. It's Ryan. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. Marcus May with the pick. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
They'll start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. His first carry of their second drive, pretty solid. And, of course, remember back to their first drive, really strong throughout that one.
Not only is he getting good blocking up front, but how about his vision to find the holes? And he's seeing things before they even open and hurtling through them.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Takes it across the 40-yard line. 13 yards to pick up there. Good for a Cleveland first.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. A shotgun snap for Watson. That's to his running back, Leonard Fournette. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Four yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6.
Considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Watson. That's out to his running back for now. And all the way down to the 5. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
He was not the primary target. They expected to get the ball downfield. Instead, checked it down. An old coach of mine used to say to us all the time, when they check it down, that should end the down. In this case, though, he foiled that in a big way and turned it into a big play.
The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. Watson now to throw. And 19.
Kenny Golladay there to make the grab. And the Browns add on to their lead.
For the extra point.
CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
Gostkowski now, after the touchdown, he'll send this one away. Bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Set to get this drive started, and they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage, or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive, but at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work? Get back to basics is usually your answer, and make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still second quarter. You get points on the board here. I think you're feeling okay. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. They'll toss it out to Carson. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. He's going to get it down to the 14-yard line. And in two plays just like that, they're already operating in the red zone.
First and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. They run it with Carson, and he'll be taken down here at about the 11. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
They went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Now, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. This is Carson, and he'll be brought a gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
They'll run with Bowen, and he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. Two, but that was enough as they'll convert to make it first and goal. This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. They'll try to run with Carson. And he's over the line and in for a Raider touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Raiders have cut it back to within a score. The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. A lot of football. Full half to be played. Taken in the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. The Browns drive about to get started. You're under a minute to go here in the half. Field position not really in your favor, but still time to try and move the ball and get in field goal range.
Yeah, you've got the lead. It's definitely a thought. Let's go ahead and try and increase it. But at the same time, I don't like the odds. I don't like where they are on the field. got the lead. They've done well in the first half. Don't mess it up and go into halftime looking at each other wondering what if.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he'll just keep two hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Call on a nickel set here for third down. Once again, they'll keep it on the ground. And they'll indeed stop him on third down. And now what do you want to do with your timeouts? Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. Colquitt on to kick as he sends it away. This is fielded at the 27. A 39-yard punt, a return of 5. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime.
Their own 32-yard line.
The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. Likely time for just one final play, and then it'll be off to the locker room to talk about how they can erase this deficit.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people look at it and go, well, maybe you take a shot here. Maybe you get some momentum going into the half. What's the flip side of that? You do something crazy, quarterback gets hit, ball comes free, and now you're down an even bigger margin. Go ahead and take this one, go to the locker room, start over.
Okay, coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. To get started. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ballgame.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. From the gun, here's Watson. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind. And we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively, just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to. How did each?
There he goes, left side. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. A big play there with his first. touchdown in his first career game. And the Raiders, they're within an extra point of tying this thing up. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14.
That ties the game at 14. Matt Prater is set to kick off.
So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away.
Fielded in the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
To get started,
and their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10.
They begin with a run by Fournette, and they'll line up with about six up past the 30 to the 31.
The ball carrier.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps, you don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
The last run got six, now second and four. Operating from the gun, Watson. It's caught on the right side at Smith. And they finally do get him, but not before he reaches the 27. It's a big play there for the Browns. 42 yards.
First down, Browns.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. They'll run with Fournette. Now he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. Leonard Fournette, 27 yards. And the Browns have taken the lead.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run, and one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
Taken in the end zone. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
25-yard line.
Offense set to get this drive started. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here.
At the 29-yard line.
From the 29 on second and six.
From the shotgun, Ryan. Here's Carson with a catch out of the backfield. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that'll bring up a third down.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
And It looks like a nickel set now for the Browns on third down. From the gun, it's Ryan. That's complete into the hands of Carson. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up fourth down. Here's Logan Cook now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. Fielded just inside the 30. Gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. We call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And the Browns will take over first and 10. The Browns drive about to get started. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments. Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
Four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. From the gun, Watson. And down he goes, brought down a Raiders sack. The sack by Harold Landry, the former Boston College Eagle. Well, it was second long, now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Something special here on third and long after that sack. What does Watson have in his arsenal? Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Call on a nickel set for third down. Operating from the gun, Watson. Got an open man here, and it's KJ Hamler. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. An incredible play there. They do get big yardage, but they're still stopped a yard or two short, and it's fourth down. Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Drive will start from deep in their own territory with a first and 10. The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
At the 16-yard line.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
On third down, Ryan. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And almost picked off. I guess the good news for them now, it's fourth down.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for them. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
The Cook now on to punt as he gets this one away. Taken right around the 44. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A solid punt, but also a nice return there of 14 yards. Now the Browns have a short field in front of them now as they take over first and 10.
Your guys see too deep into the game, into the future, and say, oh, we got to get here. No, right here, right in front of them, melt the clock down, get to the fourth quarter, try and keep going.
And try to keep that lead.
Exactly.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Off of play action, it's Watson. Ryan Kerrigan in there for the sack, and it's an important one from a personal standpoint as that is sack number 100 in what has certainly been a terrific career to this point.
Third and long.
Something special here on third and long after that sack. What does Watson have in his arsenal? From the gun, Watson. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
Here's Britton Colquitt now as he's on to punt for Cleveland. And he'll get credit for putting him inside the 20 as the fair catch is made right at about the 19-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive. Well, the defense got its job done, forcing the punt. Now the formula pretty simple. They need to find the end zone here. A field goal doesn't help them much. This will be a short gain of three before he's brought down at the 22. 3 yards the gain there, second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven. Here's Ryan. Of 20 in a first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
They'll run on first down. Carson. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, got to like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. They run again with Carson. And he's going to take this across the 50 into Browns territory.
On the carry.
That's some good tackling there to keep him short of that yellow line.
Yeah, defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to third down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play and get my defense off the field.
The Raiders on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. Here's Carson, and he's got the first down before being taken down at the 46. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Well, sometimes, Brandon, there's just not a secret to how things get done. He's been running well all game long, and they continue to rely on him in this key situation.
They told us they were going to rely on him. They have. He comes through there, a big third down conversion. Some good games around the league here early in week one, and this one shaping up to be as good as any of them as we come up on a first and 10. Off the play fake. Here's Ryan. There goes a deep ball. End zone. And it's intercepted at the line. Picked up by Molly Hooker. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
I'm not sure I'm absolutely crazy about that play call there. I mean, it's only a one-score game, so is it really time to go bombs away and try and make a big play? I think you can take some underneath stuff and still move it downfield.
The Browns drive about to get started. Another important fourth quarter series coming up. That last INT helping to maintain their slim advantage. They'll try the right side here with Fournette. He'll get about three as he's taken down at the 23.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the four fingers, fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the four fingers for 4-minute offense, and this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
Now, this is where they say, put the game on our shoulders, we'll lead the way, right?
No doubt about it. And let me tell you, if you're a running back, all you want to do is get behind those big fellas, have a little vision, and find some space.
And a solid way to do that on the first play of the drive there. Now second and seven from the 23. They'll run it again with Fournette. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
And it's third down.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. On third down, Fournette. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. Decided to hand it off that time on the run-pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
Now on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and the Raiders will take over now, first and 10.
At their own 34-yard line.
Offense set to get this drive started, and three interceptions in this game, and I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh man, I can't throw four.
No, what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. Screen pass, good for five.
To Chris Carson. A gain of five brings up second and five.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Raider football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Here's Ryan to fire this out wide. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. Now they're going to be dealing with a third and seven. Is that one officially a loss of one? Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. He's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. A pickup of 10, and it's enough for a Las Vegas first down.
That's exactly what they were looking for. If they get another gain like that, they'll be right there in field goal range.
And the tension building. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts, and they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Ryan. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
It's a pickup of six.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there.
Well, they got the yardage they needed there. Picked up the first down, got out of bounds. How about the urgency that they have, as well as the understand where they are in the field?
So first and 10 now from the 30. Ryan to throw. He's got Jack Doyle. And he'll be out of bounds, able to get it down to the 25 there. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
It didn't check off every box, but the most important one. Got the clock stopped, getting out of bounds. It may be a little short of the first down, but I thought that was the key.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Here's Ryan. Got Gordon open, completes it. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. Now the Raiders going to burn their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds left to go. Play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. One last shot for Ryan. Going for it. This is incomplete. So no miracles here on the final play, and this ball game is over. So Cleveland able to come away with the victory here. And partner, I must say, good to see you again. Been too long. And it's good to have football back, isn't it?
Didn't you see me in preseason? Weren't we together in preseason?
Yeah, but preseason, you know, it's preseason. This is week one.
Oh, you're trying to say real football.
Yeah, real football.
Not preseason football, yeah. Where we shake down the rosters and figure out who's going to play, and maybe the starters don't play as much. Now it's the frontline guys from the first whistle.
Yeah, I tuned you out in the preseason. And now I'm listening to you. So for the Browns, it was a hard-fought game, and they'll exit 1-0 as they win by a touchdown. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to the Windy City to take on the Bears. Meanwhile,